Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you about the latest from Evergrey, Escape of the Phoenix, out February 26 on AFM Records. This album has 11 tracks, 59 minutes in length, and this is the band's 12th full-length studio album. They're a Swedish progressive metal band, but I'm sure you know that by now. That's why you're watching this review. I mean, who hasn't heard of Evergrey? If you haven't, that is on you. Now, let's get into this album and let's get into the nitty-gritty of what this record has to offer. As far as the structure is concerned, I really like what they did with this album. This is an album that offers you a different look, a different feel with almost every single song. I wouldn't go as far as to say that this is a roller coaster ride or it's an album that has ups and downs. It's more an album that just changes your perception of the record itself with every single song. There is some repetition in terms of the pattern that they used. As you progress down the album, you start to feel like you almost have a sense of what's coming next. But overall, this is an album that just keeps changing what it has in store for the listener with every single track. It's also an album that it's not top heavy. And what I mean by that is it doesn't pack the best songs or the heavier songs on the album in the first quarter of the record. It's very well distributed. You're kind of going to get a little bit of everything as you go down the line. The album is as strong at the end as it is at the beginning, allowing the overall record to be very consistent and very balanced, not only from a structural perspective, but also from a soundscape approach. Getting into the soundscape, this is a record that feels very heavy. And I say it feels heavy because not necessarily every song is a heavy track. But they created an album that allows the heaviness of one track to almost permeate into the next track and still feel like it's there, it's lingering there. And there's definitely elements of heaviness that are alive on almost every single song on this album. Even the ones that are more of a ballad, they're more a little bit subdued, still have a lot of heaviness packed in there. Perhaps coming at you with different elements, with a different approach, with a different feel, but it's still there. So I really like the overall perspective that the album offers to the listener, which is an album that feels very heavy, very powerful, very strong. But when you start to break down the songs, that heaviness is not necessarily super consistent. It comes in bunches. Some songs are heavier than others. And then the ones that are not as heavy still feel heavy because the heaviness of the ones that came before kind of stick around for the ones that come after. So I like this approach, I like this overall soundscape, and I like this overall feel that the album has to offer. Now, once you get deeper into the soundscape, in my opinion, there are three elements that really control the sound and the overall experience that you're gonna get out of this album. And that is the keyboards, the drums, and the guitars. I love the keyboards on this record. We're living in an era where bands fall in love with keyboard sounds and allow them to dictate where the records are going. Not only dictating the atmosphere, the feel, the emotional drive of the records, but also pushing the album forward. They become the driver of everything that has to do with the record itself. And it's not the case on this album, and I'm glad it's not the case. The keyboards on this record play a very important role. They create atmosphere, they create melody. They really drive the message home on specific songs, allowing you to feel the song a little bit closer to your heart. You feel the emotional dripping from the keyboard sounds that permeate throughout the tracks. But they're always there as another element. They're always there as a layer. They're never sitting behind the steering wheel dictating where your experience is gonna go and where the song is pushing you towards. And I love that about this record. I love keyboard sounds, I love keyboard melodies, and I love what they can do within a metal album. I just don't like when they become the be-all and end-all of my musical experience, and that was definitely not the case with this record. The other two elements, guitars and drums, they kind of work in parallel. A lot of the heaviness, if not all of the heaviness from this record, really comes from how those two elements collaborate with each other. There's certain songs with both of them come at you very heavy together, making the overall sound on those tracks be very destructive. You almost feel this relentless approach from both drums and guitars. Then you have different styles, you have different looks. Sometimes the drums drop a little bit more to the background, allowing the guitars to push themselves to the forefront. Some tracks you have the opposite happening, the guitars pushing themselves into a more melodic perspective, allowing the drums to be that force, that heaviness that pushes the tracks forward. And I like this dynamic. They use these two elements to perfection throughout the record, bringing them together to give you the same feel, breaking them apart, allowing them to work in parallel, putting one more in the forefront, bringing the other one next. It just creates a lot of volume, creates a lot of sound. And when you look at how this record was recorded, it's very well balanced. It feels full. It feels filled with life. It feels warm. It feels rich. The sound on this album is very rich because you can break down all the different elements. You can walk through this record and pick the bass, pick the guitars, pick the drums, pick the keyboards. You can hear it. It's almost like they're coming in different channels, but then when you put them all together, they make this perfect recipe that it is Escape of the Phoenix. So I really like the collaboration of drums and guitars in order to give the essence of heaviness that this record has to offer. The guitars are still very melodic. He's still gonna get incredible solos throughout this record, really over the top, almost exploding onto the songs, bringing a lot of light, a lot of presence, a lot of substance, if you will, into how the songs feel, into how they move, and into how they were constructed. But the partnership with the drums is extremely important for that heaviness, because that's one of the main condiments of this album. That heaviness is really permeating throughout the whole record. And like I said earlier, they were able to create songs that were very heavy and then songs that were not so heavy, but they still feel heavy because of everything that's come before them. Once you look at the big picture of this album, it's hard to pick an Evergrey record and start to be very negative about it, or start to pick things apart and say that, wow, they could have done this better, they could have done that better. I don't think these guys can ever do anything better than what they've already done. This album is proof of that. When you look at this record, I really don't see a lot of soft spots. Perhaps if you want to be super critical about this album, you could say that, wow, I wish the heaviness was a little bit more consistent, and I wish the heaviness was not just in some songs one of the elements. I wanted this to be a heavy album from beginning to end. You can make that argument for this album, but I don't think that's the right approach to take. You need Evergrey to be able to morph, to evolve with their sound and allow the songs to have different emotions, to have different feels, to bring something different from you. And if the album had that heaviness in the forefront, if that was the driving force of this album, the album would become super repetitive. What you would get emotionally out of the first track would be exactly what you would get out of the last track and everything in between. So having an album that allows you to feel different things with every single song, but still keeping a little bit of that heartbeat, of that heaviness alive throughout it, to me is the perfect balance for this album and is the perfect balance for this band. I still think this is one of their heavier albums in the last couple of years. So definitely has more of a bite, definitely has a lot of strength to it, but it also offers you a little bit of everything this band has ever done, just with the rougher edges, if you will. Now, if you're gonna go into songs, there are three that I picked outside of the singles that I really love, that I really enjoy, and I wanna start off with Where August Mourn. Great sounding track. This is the second song on the album, and it kind of gives you a glimpse of what this record is gonna be all about. The keyboards sound very futuristic. They're not there throughout the whole song. It's not like you're gonna hear them from the first note all the way to the last note. They're gonna come in and out, permeating throughout the record, giving you this fragrance, giving you this harmony, but also this incredible atmosphere that's really important for the lyrics, but also for how this song feels on an emotional perspective. And I love the sound that they bring to the forefront, but it doesn't dictate the tempo, it doesn't dictate where this song is gonna go. Very dynamic track. I love the mixture of more melodic, subtle approach, very melodic, subtle approach with the heavier side of the song, which is also gonna be the heavier side of the album. So this track kind of gives you a glimpse of how this whole record is put together from a song construction perspective. A lot of melody, a lot of heaviness, blending those two elements together, you sprinkle in some keyboard, consistent vocals all the way through. On top of that, one of the most outstanding solos on this record is on this track. I just love it. It has a little bit of an old school feel, very proggy in the way it's put together and the way it's structured. It really enhances the beauty of the song. It really enhances the overall atmosphere that this track has to offer. I love this song. I love how it evolves, how it moves, and then how consistent the vocals stay, keeping it together all the way through. Next, In the Absence of Sun, my favorite song on the album, and it's not the heaviest song on the album. That just goes to show that these guys can create really interesting tracks that really bring something from you to the outside that you not even knew you had it on the inside. This is one of those tracks I just connected with a little bit of the darkness, a little bit of the pain that this track had. It's a beautiful ballad, but it's a ballad that doesn't stay that way all the way through. It's your almost prototypical metal ballad. It grows, it morphs, it always works itself from the darkness into the light. The darkness, more melodic, more somber, if you will. Then once you start to reach the light, the song explodes, becoming a little bit heavier, be having more power, more strength, more aggression, if you will. And that's exactly how this song moves. This is how this song evolves and grows and it morphs. And I love how it sounds. And this is a track that is ignited by the vocals. Still very consistent in their approach from the beginning all the way to the end, but giving you enough changes in order for the track to reignite itself. So when you go through the more somber moments of the song, the more darker moments of the song, the vocals represent that same emotion, that same feel, that same atmosphere. As the song starts to grow, as the song starts to move, so do the vocals. The vocals start to morph, they become a little bit more aggressive, they have a little bit more intent in them. And when they explode on the track, so does the song musically. So I love the dynamic, I love the yin and yang, the Jekyll and Hyde aspect that this song has, and it's absolutely a beautiful track, top to bottom. Last but not least, Escape of the Phoenix, that is the title of the record, and this song is interesting from that perspective, not just because it's the title of the record, but because of how it's constructed and how it comes together. One of the most consistently heavier songs on the album. It just stays heavy. It doesn't just start heavy, it stays heavy all the way through. It's heavy at the beginning, it's heavy in the middle, and it's heavy at the end. I love how it sounds, I love the strength that it has, and it comes later in the album, proving what I said earlier, that this is not a top heavy album. This is an album that stays very consistent, that offers you different looks, but it doesn't break apart from beginning all the way to the end. It's as strong at the end as it is at the start. And this song is just proof of that. But this is a track that stays very together, very well connected all the way through, keeping that heaviness alive, keeping that consistency going, the vocals being the glue that holds it all together, that doesn't allow the song to break apart, and moving it at a fast pace, at a heavier pace, with a lot of intent, with a lot of intensity, with a lot of purpose. This is it, Evergrey, Escape of the Phoenix, out February 26 on AFM Records. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.